Welcome back, everybody. Hope everybody's been doing well. It's been a busy few weeks for me and some bad weather, so haven't been able to really do a video. But I did want to bring out the newest gun that I have, and this is the Canik TP9SF. I got this. I ended up selling the Taurus G3. Nothing wrong with it. I met somebody that had been looking for one in my area. Nobody had any. And he offered me a lot more money than what I paid for it, which, it's a Taurus. I thought it was stupid, but I'm not going to argue. Anyway, I replaced the G3 with the Canik, and technically it's pronounced Janik, but this is America. We say Canik, spelled with a C. We say it with a C. Get over it. So, this is the TP9SF, and more specifically, this is the 1 series. So it is the low man on the totem pole. It's very basic. You get one magazine, the pistol, chamber flag, and trigger lock. That's it. It's all that comes in it. Still comes in the nice hard case, but you don't get the extra mag. You don't get the holster that usually comes with these, and I don't like them anyway. They're the Serpa style holster that says Canik on the side of it. I had one of the original TP9 models that came out, early, mid-2000s, roughly. And, that was a great gun until it broke. The gun itself didn't break. Let me put that out there. I put thousands and thousands of rounds through that pistol. Never had an issue with the gun itself. What I had an issue with was their sights. They used Walther compatible rear adjustable sights. The front sight, however, was their own design, and it's similar to the, I guess, the old style Glock sights. There was just a little small rectangular hole cut in the slide. The sight popped in, and it was held in place with a little set screw. Well, at some point, the set screw came loose, the front sight popped off, and Canik stopped supporting the original TP9. They have no parts for it. So, thankfully, in the box, when I originally bought that one, it came with interchangeable front sights. So you got a small, a medium, and a large. The medium one was the sweet spot. It was good up close. It was good out to probably 35, 40 yards. It was pretty much dead on at 25 yards with the middle, you know, the medium sight. That popped off. I tried one of the other ones. Just didn't shoot the same. I didn't like it anymore. I got rid of it. Anyway, this one is a major, major upgrade to that. No longer has the decocker. It is not single and double action like the original one. Still has the same grip and grip texture as the original, as far as I can remember. It does have the interchangeable back straps, which I don't have the extra one out here with me. The one that came on it, to me, is the one that feels the best, so I just left that one on there. This one only does come with the 1 magazine. And if you want to get another one, normally you can order them. Canik, Gun Mag Warehouse, everybody that I checked, just those two right off the top of my head, but everybody that I checked was completely out of these magazines. However, I did find on a website called Grab a Gun, and you know, I've never heard of them before. It just popped up during my search. They had these by ProMag, and it works fine. The only complaint I have is that right there, where this shows you how many rounds is in it. This one does not. It's just a guessing game. You have to count when you're loading them. But this one is my backup mag anyway. So, and you can see I've got some Blazer aluminum, which I picked up for like $14.99, a box of 50 from Academy Sports. I was out at the range, and this one just still happens to be loaded, so I'll slide that one out of the way. Like I said, this one is the factory mag. And the Pro Mag is made very well. I just wish they would actually put the view holes in it. But anyway, it's an excellent gun. I have zero complaints. It shoots very well. A couple of things that I do like about this one over the original one are the sights. They are dovetailed in now, like most manufacturers do. And these sights are actually Warren Tactical. I don't know if I can get that to focus. Focus. Okay, so it doesn't seem to want to focus on there for me right now. But there we go. Yeah, Warren Tactical. I think I might have it upside down there. Let's see if I can get that to focus again. Anyway, Warren Tactical. And it is a blacked out rear sight and a white dot front. And I like that. This is the only pistol that I have that has a blacked out rear, and I prefer this over any other style sights. Very easy to pick up. Let's see if I can make it focus there. There we go. Very easy to pick up. Non-glare rear sight on it. There we go. And it is clear. The magazine is out. Chamber's clear. So when I was pointing it at my hand, it was safe. It wasn't even cocked. Now you can see it is cocked. You can see the cocked indicator there. Also has a loaded chamber indicator up here. One of the things that I absolutely love about this is the trigger. And I know a lot of people have said they like the trigger on these. And this one does have the little blade safety on the trigger there. But trigger basically comes back to right there. It's a hard stop. And then click. The reset is right there. So, do that. Right there. I mean, very, very nice trigger. Very crisp break. It does have that little bit of take up until you get to that little wall, and then it just squeezes. I mean, it's very, very nice for a $300 gun. I think I paid $350 for it, roughly, because everything is still a little elevated right now. But usually, you can get these right around $300, sometimes even less than $300. But it's a very, very good gun. It does come with a match-grade barrel, even the cheaper version. Barrels on these are match grade. They're extremely accurate, very reliable. They haven't been around as long as Glocks and Smith & Wesson and 6 Hour and all that stuff. But as long as I've had them, as much as I've shot them, I would be willing to put my life on the line with this pistol, as well as a Glock or a Smith & Wesson or a Ruger or any of the big name brands. And this is a fraction of the cost. My Ruger American, it's a 45 caliber. I paid almost $600 for that thing. It was like $599. And I don't think I actually paid taxes on it. The shop I bought it from bought it brand new. And he sold it to me for the $599, taxes included. He did the same thing with this. I think this was $359, I believe. And he sold it to me without adding the extra taxes to it. He let me walk out for $359. That's because I do buy most of my stuff from him. But, yeah, if anybody has any questions about anything, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'll try to answer everybody's stuff. I did also want to point out one of the reasons that I chose this over getting another Taurus or anything else, really. Number one was the price. Number two was the quality. I know they've been great, great firearms. I've never had an issue with, even with the older model, with the gun itself. It was the sight that I had an issue with, but the function of the pistol itself, I've never had a hang up at all. Never had a failure to feed, failure to fire, failure to eject. That was the gun's fault. I think I had one failure to fire, and that was the ammo. It was not the pistol. And that was with the older one. So that was some of the reasons. Another one of the reasons is because I like oddball stuff. Although Canik has grown in popularity over the past few years, especially with the TP9SFX, it's like $500 to $600 depending on what options you get. It's optics ready. It's got the flared magwell. It comes with 20 round magazines. It's got the little ports cut into the barrel or to the slide. It is a competition-ready pistol for $500 or $600 over something like the CZ Shadow. That's like in the thousands, like $1,200, $1,300, $1,400, $1,500, something stupid like that. And you get the same reliability and accuracy for $500 or $600. So they have gained a lot in popularity over the last few years. It is also a military and police pistol for the Turkish military and police, and it was deemed good enough to be considered by the Danish Army. They recently went through a pistol program similar to what the U.S. did when they were looking for a replacement for the M9, the Beretta 92, and they chose the Sig Sauer P320, the M17, M18. This was part of the Danish military trials. They had the Smith & Wesson M&P 2.0. They had the Canik TP9SF, this exact model. They had the Sig Sauer. They had the Beretta APX. And they had the Glock 19. The Smith & Wesson was the first one to be dropped for performance issues. And the four remaining ones, this one included, I don't know how many more were dropped before a final decision was made, but ultimately the Danish military ended up going just like the US with the Sig Sauer. One of the main reasons being that this particular pistol does not come from the factory with an optics cut on it, and the Sig Sauer does. This one is also not a modular system like the Sig Sauer. So they wanted something that was going to be, modular, where you can just take the fire control group out, replace the frame, replace the slide, whatever. This one didn't do that. This one also wasn't optics ready, where the Sig Sauer is. So Sig Sauer won their contract, but this one did very, very well. As a matter of fact, from what I understand, it was one of the more accurate pistols. It passed all of the torture testing that they did. So did the Glock. But again, they went with the Sig Sauer. Anyway, I figure if it's good enough for militaries, multiple militaries, because the Danish tried it and the Turkish did adopt it, it's good enough for me. And again, I like oddball stuff. One of the pistols that I used to have that I had to get rid of for financial reasons, I would love to get it back, and that is the Arcus 98 DAC. I love that. It's very heavy, all steel, not even alloy. It's a steel frame. Magnets will stick to every single part of it. And it is a 9mm that is very, it's very hard to find, first of all. And second of all, not a lot of people know about it, but it is a clone of the Browning High Power. It was a great shooting gun, very low recoil, 9mm. It's very, very heavy. But that one was adopted by the Iraqi police. And that one is made in Bulgaria, I believe is where Arcus is made. But after I got rid of it, nobody else has them. I cannot find them being imported anywhere. I can't find them used for sale. One I bought, paid $350 for it, brand new. You know, life happens. And so I've been building my collection back. And that is one that I would love to have back. So if anybody knows of anyone that's looking to get rid of it, let me know. But anyway, I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch this video. Like, share it, subscribe to me, and I'll see you next time.